Yes, welcome back, welcome back. You know, my first guest tonight has earned 18 gold and 13 platinum albums with the rock group Kiss. And he's now starring as an assassin in the new film Wanted, Dead or Alive. Please welcome Gene Simmons. Okay. Listen, you know, some of the people at home, as well as here, may not remember Gene ever having short hair. This is a first.
So this is a wig.
Yeah, it's even shorter than this.
It's even shorter than that. I just cut it for the film.
Yeah, for the film. So we want to show the people you in your regular Kiss makeup.
Oh, you've got it?
Yeah, we got a little picture of you here, if you watch the monitor. And this is what you look like.
Where?
See, right there. That's how you look.
What is that thing sticking out of
I don't know. It looks like a car. I guess you're laying out the red carpet for someone. You know, it's interesting. I'll tell you something. I knew, it kind of would come as a surprise to some people. I knew you were Jewish, but that's because I know every Jewish person in the world, you know.
Well, I still am.
Yeah, you're still Jewish, right?
No,
you maintain that for the,
yes.
But what surprised me is I didn't know that you were actually Israeli. You were born in Israel.
Yes, I was.
And I didn't know on top of that that you had once thought of becoming a rabbi.
Mm-hmm.
Now, that's a strange thought.
First of all, where did you get all this information?
Well, we have a staff of rabbinical students who go around doing research on all Jewish people who appear.
I'm the straight man, and he's going to go into this. It's true.
What changed your mind? I mean, what first made you think of it, and then what changed your mind?
Well, girls changed my mind, number one.
Yeah.
Actually, at a certain point when I was a lot younger, I felt... Well, when I first came to this country, I couldn't speak a word of English. So you get put into this institution to keep you off the streets, basically. And as soon as I saw the first girl at about 13 or 12 years of age, I said, this is too good. I got to have some of this. And so...
So there went the rabbi.
There went the rabbi out the door. Cut off my long peyot is what they're called.
Right.
Pieces of hair that dangle from here. And a guitar magically appeared around my neck. And from then on, it's been good times all the way.
Well, we have a... we were trying to think of a concept because just... You know, it really just blew me out, the idea of you being a rabbi, you know, knowing you like...
Well, I never became one.
Right, but the idea that you might have, see, and what we did is we sort of anticipated, like, what it might have been like, and we have here a picture of what you might have been like had you have become a rabbi. This is a rabbi... What? Now, the business you would have drummed up...
I think it's a good gimmick.
How's it going? Yeah,
come on.
A new group, right? A new group. Kiss me if you want. If you don't want, don't kiss, you know.
or for you, I got a concert.
Yeah, for you, I got a concert. When you know, this interesting thing, you had the anonymity. No one knew who you were as yourself. Right. Now you're made up. Now, there has to be a moment, a decision, when you think you have everything that's positive about a career. You got the money from it, you got the popularity from it, you got the recognition for your craft from it, and yet you don't have the negatives. You're not hassled in public, no one recognizes you, and you guarded it very well, the mystique was there.
Sounds good.
What happened that all of a sudden, when did you decide, you said, you know what, I'm going to take it off, and now people are going to know me from now on. That has to be a decision, because you had the best of all the worlds there.
The truth is that we decided to put the paint on for a completely different reason. It's more, pretty much like the guy that stands on the corner and exposes himself. Hey lady, look at this. It's just to get attention. And after 10 years of doing it, I think if you do something for too long, you wind up being a caricature of yourself. And there are too many bands that ape what we do anyway. And so sometimes to take two steps forward, you take a step back. So we took the makeup off. Just to feel a little fresher about it after 10 years. It's been 13 now, and without the makeup, it's doing very well. Thanks.
Yeah, it has been. Your face, you got an interesting face without the makeup.
You're a pretty good looking guy yourself.
Well.
What does that mean?
Thank you. But your face, I know your face actually got you into the movies in a strange way. When you did Runaway, and the producer said, when you went to see him about the part, he said, don't say anything. He said, just look at me, look at my eyes, and think like you want to rip my heart out.
That's right? True.
And you made this face and got the part in Runaway. Now, what I didn't see, no one else did, that look. If you would, for everybody, look in that camera and look like you want to rip the heart out of it. Let's see the look that got you.
That one or that?
This one right here. Let's see that look.
That one?
Yeah.
Okay. Is that the look?
Yeah, that's a good look. Yeah. Now, I want you to look at me, Gene, like I want to rip my nose off. This film, now you play a bad guy in Runaway.
Yeah, I'm a real bad guy.
Right, bad guy. Yeah. Then you go a step beyond, you play even a guy that makes him look tame. You get even worse. So you're getting real evil now in this Wanted, Dead or Alive.
Wanted, Dead or Alive. Rutger Hauer is the good guy.
Yeah.
And, oh.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's the good guy this time. Maybe my next film I'll be the good guy. But anyway, he's the good guy this time, and I'm the bad guy. I'm a terrorist who has come on a personal vendetta against this guy. See, you're even doing the eyes as I'm talking
about
it.
Yeah, sure, you can feel that.
He's getting the feeling.
Evil, you got the evil.
And I come after him, and I've got to get his attention first, so I decide to kill some innocent people.
Is that the clip we have where you...
The clip is pretty much at the beginning of the movie, and you'll get a sense of what kind of a movie this is. At the beginning of the movie, I call the newspapers to let them know that Malak al-Rahim, that's the name of the guy, is in town. And I'm calling the newspaper to let them know that I'm here, and the guy doesn't believe me. I'll let you see what happens.
Okay, watch your monitors. At home, watch your televisions. No.
Morrison, City Desk, how can I help you?
This is Malak al-Rahim. Let me save you a little confusion, Mr. Morrison. Tonight you'll be receiving phone calls from a number of people claiming responsibility for what I am about to do.
Malak al-Rahim is supposed to be in South Yemen. How do I know it's actually you?
You'll know it was me. I'm outside of Fox Cinema.
There have been many, many times that I haven't liked a film, but I never got that crazy, you know what I mean?
Well, the guy felt like leaving his...
You know, you walk out of theater, I hated that movie. I want to tell you something. I think you got a great face for the films.
Thank you.
Always enjoyed you.
Thank you. And
I want to wish you the best of luck in all the careers you have. You're a terrific guy.
Thank you.
We're going to take a break and come back with more Nightlife right after this.